Hello, welcome to today's video where I'll be covering my webcomic process in Clip Studio Paint. In the previous video, I went over how I set up my comic pages and draw my sketches. Today I'll be discussing my line art inking process. Links to additional tutorials and information for everything mentioned in today's video will be down in the description. To start, I like to change the layer color of my pencil sketches to a lighter color using the layer color function and make sure my rough thumbnail sketches are hidden. By setting the thumbnail sketch layer as a draft layer in the layers window, I can be sure the sketch won't be visible in the final export later. I always draw my line art on a vector layer. To make a vector layer, click on the cube symbol in the layers window. Since my panels are broken up into folders, I put one in each folder. There are a lot of benefits to using vector layers for line art, but in my opinion, the most useful features for comics are the line art customizability and intersectional erasing. By using vector layers, you can adjust your lines after they've already been drawn, which is incredibly helpful when trying to keep your comic consistent and manageable. After drawing a line on your vector layer, you can select it by going to the Object tool in the Operations subtool menu. You can adjust which customization options are available by clicking the wrench icon at the bottom right and toggling the Eye button next to whatever feature you'd like visible on the menu. Another feature I find useful is intersectional erasing. With your eraser brush selected, go to the Tool Property menu and make sure the Vector Eraser box is checked under the subtool Detail Settings. Then click the second option to enable the Erase Up to Intersection mode. Now you can erase sections of overlapping lines in your line art without disturbing the rest of the drawing. This makes the process a lot faster once you get the hang of it. Over time, I've learned a few other useful tips for working with line art that will make starting out as a beginner a lot easier. If you're anything like me, you may occasionally struggle with your line art coming out wobbly, so you have to draw the same line a few times over and over until you get it looking right. If that's the case for you too, I recommend adjusting the stabilization setting on your line art brush. In the Subtool Detail panel, you'll find the stabilization slider under the Correction category. By raising the number on the slider, you can adjust how stabilized your lines are. Now when you draw your lines, they should come out smoother and slower. You can adjust the slider to find a speed that works best for your lines. If you've worked with digital art before, you may have encountered something known as anti-aliasing. Anti-aliasing is the smoothing effect that is applied to brushes to make them look softer and less pixelated. If you zoom in on your drawing, you can notice little fuzzy edges around your line art. This is anti-aliasing. In Clip Studio Paint, you can control the hardness of a brush's anti-aliasing by going to the anti-aliasing category of the Subtool Detail panel. For comic inking, using a hard edge brush can help make your lines clearer at any size. If you've ever tried resizing a picture before, you might have noticed that the smaller a picture gets, the fuzzier it becomes. If you plan to post your webcomic online, you may have to reduce its size to fit that site's standards. By using a hard brush for your line art, you can be sure your line art will stay visible even if the comic is sized down a lot. One easy way to turn all your brushes into hard-edged ones without changing their anti-aliasing settings is to change the expression color of your line art layer to monochrome in the Layer Property panel. As long as you're drawing on this layer, your lines will come out with hard edges that are ideal for inking your comic. Those are the basics for how I do my inking process. In the next episode, I'll be going over my coloring process, including some tips for making character swatches, color adjusting, and quickly filling in your line art. Check the description below for my social media links and more tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time.